You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... 20 years tops. Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? You better not have gone to the village alone! I bet your fever hasn't even gone down! Lafayette been here?
No. I haven't seen him.
Wait! That's one of Arthur's!
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand? He must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet! I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest.
I was going to have them join the search, but they won't move at all. It's like they're scared of something.
I know. He might have gone to the Cape to pick flowers. Have you seen Lafayette?
Nope. Can't say that I have.
All right. Let me know the second you see him.
Got it. Is he in bad shape?
Well, he refuses to stay in bed. He needs his rest, but he's always walking around or reading outside.
I can't say I'm surprised. He's always been a curious lad. He likes reading difficult books. When I saw him the other day, he told me all about the latest navigation techniques and exotic farming methods, too. Only one kid in a million is as smart as he is.
You're exaggerating. Well, maybe not.
It's a shame. If he could go to school in the capital, I'm sure he'd make a name for himself as a scholar.
The capital? Isn't that days and days by ship from Taliesin? No way! Not happening. Even if he gets better, I could never let him go that far away all by himself.
He can handle it. He's actually a very responsible boy. I don't think you need to worry.
I couldn't handle it. I would worry. And be lonely.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to be another Scarlet Night.
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago. But what is it anyway?
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one by watching the movements of the stars. According to legend, a crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof of humanity's sins.
You sure know a lot about it.
Lafayette taught me just a few minutes ago.
You saw Luffy?
Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
Aww. Fluffy!
Velvet.
Can you walk? How's your fever?
I'm fine. I was just taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Lafayette. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the Cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
Remember how we went out together to pick Princessias on the morning of Celica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only 4, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of course I did. Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too?
You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you. He'll help the world. He's quite the guy.
That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe.
I know. I'm sorry, sis.
But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of Princessia were blooming.
I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica.
That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what Princessia flowers signify?
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come.
Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Luffy.
Yeah. Me too, sis.
How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Luffy?
Apple boo? What's that?
Grated apples. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart and juicy and crisp. Eating it always made me feel better.
Well, apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
When I was a baby, I would always say boo-boo when I wanted to eat an apple.
So that's where the name comes from. Wait, you called apples boo-boo? You must have been a strange baby.
You used to do the same thing. When Celica and I heard you, we laughed so hard.
Boo!
Just look at all these! This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy. Do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food. Or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to...
coffee set. Run! No matter how much it hurts, run! Velvet! Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't!
Go! Why is a demon here?
I don't want to go alone!
You have to! Don't let your feelings get in the way, or that thing will kill you too!
But
please, go! Dang it! It's just like Arthur said. I have to do this! Stop! Face me, demon! How did I get home?
Velvet!
Luffy, you're all right.
Sorry, it's all my fault.
No, if you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Scarlet Knight? What's going on? Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't!
You.
Oh, thank goodness. You kept Luffy safe, didn't you, Arthur?
One more sentiment to cast off.
Velvet, run! Arthur!
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lockett's life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
Go. This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you will not change. Ever a slave to emotion. Feeds on demons.
Arthur.
A Therian.
Arthur!
Answer me!
take a look around. Demon blight has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorias Colbrand, will end your pain. Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer. Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
I will make you pay!
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years, I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him and be my brother's vengeance.
Where is he? First, there will be a test. It will decide if you are worth teaching. Here I come!
If you are not,
I will kill you. Ready yourself.
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of... Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is. You may find him in the capital city of Logris in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malakim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcists quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcist's Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people and a sword against demons, Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafiset.
Indeed. But his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
Escape? So that's your game. Fine. I don't care what the world thinks of me. What matters is my vengeance against Artorias. That's all.
I have shattered your yoke. We must hurry.